live. If you've seen my YouTube video with my electro etching, I've basically etched the front of this 20 gauge piece of sterling silver. And this is what I'm going to use to then fabricate my cuff, is what I'm making here right now. I've gotten everything, I've green scrubbed. I made sure to clean off my metal nice and well so that we have our solder will want to flow. It'll also give the solder some tooth to then to hold on to the metal. So first off, what I'm going to do is I'm going to get my torch going, and then I am going to use some Prips Flux, which is a high heat flux, and it helps prevent fire scale. Also, I'm using a number 5 torch tip, so this is going to be a big flame. So I'll have to have a decent amount of heat control here. Now it's not hot, so I'm using my hands for the moment until it gets crisps. Alright, so now I'm flip this over. I like to have everything kind of where I have it, where I can easily grab it, kind of like a dentist. We got a dentist in the class right now. So now I'm just gonna get that heated up, and then I'll get my clips on if my bottom wants to work right. I'm gonna reach across real quick. I'm gonna use that. You're good. There we go. That spray bottle works a little better. And just for information's sake, the pattern that I have etched on here is a Damascus steel type pattern. Makes a really nice pattern. Alright, got that nice and crisp, and flip these guys over. Do that again. I want to make sure I have this on all sides, because this is also the flux too, so it'll be necessary to help the solder flow. Set this up now. Sometimes I'll have my torch going as I do this, but thought for video's sake, so we can see what's happening here and for time purposes. I like to have my pieces extended out. I'll just come back and clean this up afterwards. Gives me room for error. Piece to the end here. I'm gonna use what's called a stick or probe solder. Mm-hmm. Which I've already got them set up here. So now I'm set. I'm gonna go across one more time with a little bit of Prips that kind of helps glue things in place, and then I will be ready to solder this down. good. All right, here we go. Got my solder pick too. Have it handy. If there's any slight adjustments, I can kind of go in and move things around a little bit. And then I'm getting that close to temp. I'm just going to lay some solder in. This other side too. I see I've gotten a little bit of movement here. Got a little solder where I didn't want it, but now I'm using the walls, my side rails basically, as a little bit of a lift, keeping my solder from balling up. Starting to get a little flow. Doing that, doing a little more than I wanted. But got the solder flowing over there. I like to use the Lazy Susan, that way I can come around to move my piece around rather than having to move my torch. That's just the way I've learned. There we go. Pop it up to not get it too hot. It was starting to get a little hot there. And also, get my... I accidentally grabbed a piece that was a slightly different gauge here of my wire, so that's why I'm raised there. I'll fix that though later. This is a decent mass. The mass of metal is pretty significant here, so it does take a little while sometimes to get it up to temp to get it to flow. But it's happening. Pop it up. Pop it up. As soon as I pop up off of it, the temperature drops immediately. And that's kind of how I'm controlling my heat. Might I be able to ask one of you guys, would you just go on to those two pieces there, if I need it, a couple pieces of solder, thank you. And get some more solder laid in here, hopefully I don't need it, but... Should be enough for me. Let's see, as soon as, like I said, as soon as you take that heat away, then I gotta bring it back up to temp. Alright, now we're starting to flow again. Side rails are down. Right here. Just kind of pulling the solder through. I can see it's nice flowing. I can see it come through. Thank you, Lenny. goes in. Just a smidge on my little end pieces here. Get more broad than I wanted, but there we go. Just lift that out. And I think I am I should be good to go. And that is how you solder up a almost 2 ounce piece of silver cuff. I'll have to let that cool down and nice little trick I like to use here for it to release from my brick. A lot of times I know people are used to having pieces of their brick come up off their onto their metal. You get some steam action going on there, and it should still stuck a little bit. It'll just pop right off. There we go. Yep. Come off clean. There we go. Pickle that, and I'll have cleanup to do. So that's the solder.